Today, I will talk about communicative methodology, which has been extensively used in his research. And Aitor is a collaborator with Norman Denzin. That's the big name in communicative research.
Today, I'm talking about the social impact related to communicative methodology. Of course, it's the methodology that we use in our research group in Spain. And I'm here because I'm leading, as Dusan said, the Saleacom project. And for this reason, I want first to introduce a little bit Saleacom, because also in Saleacom we are analyzing different successful educational actions, and it's linked also with this kind of communicative methodology, okay? And it's the reason that I'm here. But this is only a short introduction, and later I want to introduce the concept of impact and related to the social science and humanities agenda in Europe. It's more centered in Europe, but nowadays this social impact, political impact, is so important, not only in Europe, okay? It's trespassing, I think, our frontiers in Europe. Later, I want to introduce communicative methodology, but link it also to social impact, okay? And I'm introduce a little bit the theoretical basis and three of the main points of the communicative methodology that I think that is the most important, in order to put some differences to other methodologies. And later, two examples of social impact using communicative methodology. While I'm introducing the social impact, I will introduce also, and I show you, because it's in internet, the CIOR is an open repository with international projects that shows that this is possible, to have social impact, political impact, and scientific impact working in social science and humanities. Okay, this is first the Saleacom. This is Saleacom, overcoming inequalities in schools and learning communities. This is leading by my university, Rovira and Virgili. It's located in Tarragona, near to Barcelona in Spain. Funded by Marie Curie Action. It's a recent, it's research innovation staff exchange. It's a project funded by the European Commission, and the idea is to establish a permanent network. Okay, it's a project for 3 years. We are in the second year, and for this reason, I was past year here working. Our partners are from here. It's Lori Santa Maria, working with the MAC, with the Mobile Pacifica. From the Queensland University of Technology, this is Joe Lampert and Bruce Bennett. In Stanford, we have Arnitha Ball, working with also Latino and Afro-Americans. Leuf Karts is the University of São Carlos, is near to Rio de Janeiro in Brazil, working with, they call it, the Negro population and with affirmative actions. Central European University is located in Hungary, in Budapest, and they work with Roma community. And this is the, this girl is the symbol of Drumkotar Mestipen. It's a way of freedom. It's a Roma Women Association, and it's placed in Barcelona. We are all our universities, but there is only the participation of an association, and it's the Drumkotar Mestipen. This is more the expertise of each of the participate of the partners. We also now we are including University of Barcelona and Autonomous University of Barcelona working with us in the same team in Spain, working with the successful educational actions around in communities. And this is the expertise of the rest of the partners. The idea is to create this network and exchange the experience of each of the partners. Okay. This is the population that we are working. We are working with the Roma. This is also original, from Australia, from Brazil, as migrants, low-income population, Afro-Americans, in the case of Arnitha Ball. And the idea is trying to overcome the obstacles or the situation of this directly excluded in each participant country. This is the aims of the project. We are working now mainly in the second one, in this second period, to provide high quality training programs for teachers and educational researchers. But the main objective is the last one, to create a global program of successful educational actions to implement adverse educational systems. This is the main idea of the project. Okay, but this is only to situate the reason that I'm here, okay? But today we are working on this matter, impact on the social science and humanities agenda. In Europe, the Marie Curie, this project is funded by Horizon 2020. In the last framework, in the past, there is the framework programs, the six, the seven framework programs. Okay, this is the most successful research project in Europe, the most recognized. And they moved from framework programs to Horizon 2020. Now, and Europe 2020 is, we can found the objectives that we need to reach this year, the 2020, in Europe, okay? And the idea is connect the objectives of Europe 2020 with the objectives of the DG, okay? The different research directions related to research and innovation that there is funded by the European Commission. Okay? This is the main goals of the European of the Europe 2020 strategy. You have clear connection with employment, GDP, also with climate changes, improving education, the idea of overcome the poverty rates. And we are working with impact that I will introduce shortly later. We are working with this objective. The idea is if Europe needs to arrive to these objectives for the 2020, in 4 years, we need to, with our research funded by the European Commission, we need to work in this line. Okay? If we are working, in education, we need to work in this. For instance, in this, the fourth point. Okay? Of course, there are many different projects funded by the European Commission. But the idea is following these general goals and targets, or other international targets, because there are, this is in Europe, but in the States and internationally, there are also another kind of targets, but so similar to these ones. Yeah. The idea is to have a positive impact in the population, in terms of employment or GDP or education, okay? In our case, with Saleacom, we are working, of course, with the idea to improve education working with the most vulnerable groups, yeah? One of the problems that appears 3 years ago was because there was a questioning of the social science and the humanities worldwide, okay, and also, of course, in Europe, and coinciding also with the crisis, okay. In the case of Spain, for instance, the Spanish government cut the funding for the social science and humanities. In our case, for instance, in the University of Virgili, mainly they invest in technology and chemics, because all the industry of chemics are located in Tarragona, in Spain. And there is only a few percentage invested in social science, okay? And in the case of Europe, the European Commission wants to cancel, okay? The Commission wants to cancel the money, the budget, for the social science and humanities, in the first draft of the Horizon 2020, okay? But at the end, there are many academics in Europe trying to stop this first draft, okay? And trying to explain that it's necessary to have budget for social science and humanities, of course. But was in a tenure track by now, okay? The main critique is that it's so difficult, in social science and humanities to demonstrate that we have a social impact, okay? And in chemistry and in technologies, it's easiest, no? Because they create a product, and the product has an impact, a concrete impact, no? In the population, okay? And sometimes, in our case, no? In social science and humanities, there are a lot of explanations, theories, okay? But it's not really a concrete impact. In terms of, if you are working in education, for instance, the European Commission wants that you have an impact, no? In terms of trying to overcome, no? The dropout, no? Or a school failure. Okay, this is the idea. If you are working in your research project in the area of economy, they want to that with your project you can contribute, no? To the GDP, or you can contribute, no? Increasing decreasing the unemployment rates, for instance. Okay. At the end, they include in the final Horizon 2020 program in this sixth point, no? Inclusive, innovative, and reflective societies. And they include this budget. But it's under, no, it's an attendance track. No? Now they want to know if really the social no, the social science and humanities projects funded by the European Commission has a really impact in the population. Okay? And for this reason, they funded the impact project that I will introduce briefly. This is the impact, no, in the research agenda. For instance, this is the CIS project, no, the first conference on social impact of sciences that took place the last days of July. That we organized our center, our research center, CREA in Barcelona. But there are different initiatives. For instance, in the UK, they are working in this line. They create a research excellence framework formed by different higher educational institutions working in this line. Okay, because and for instance, in Spain, working in this way now, if you want to present a research project, a proposal. To the Spanish Ministry of Education or Economy Defense, okay, for research and development, you need to demonstrate how you reach the social impact or the political impact. Okay? This is so important. No? For the evaluators of the research proposals, they have no a concrete criteria, and one of these criteria is to have this social impact. And of course, the European Commission is the same with the research projects. For instance, in Nature, no, in the review appears, no, what do scientists do for society? And there are many, many different examples of biology, chemistry, technology that they are working really to have an impact, no, creating this kind of new products or new medicines. Okay, but it's not so clear in our case. Okay, in social science and humanities. And this is. Well, Ramon Flecha, Marta Soler, and Teresa Sorde are members of our research group, CREA. They published in Nature about the social impact, yeah? And they talk about, no, metrics such as social improvement, transferability to the diverse populations or social contexts are also used to buy research proposals. The idea is that we need to incorporate, no, this idea to have social impact, to have, no, to reach the social impact in the population. We need to incorporate also in our research proposals, no? From the very beginning until the end. Okay? And for this reason, no? For this, that is so difficult, no? To show, no? The social impact, no? in our area, the European Commission founded the Impact ED project, evaluating the impact and outcomes of the European social science and humanities research from 2014 to 2017. The project is led by Ramon Flecha, one of the authors of the article, and it is directly linked to this idea, no, to demonstrate that if there is really no social impact, no, in the research in Europe or not. Okay, we are evaluating the different projects from the sixth and seventh framework program from Europe. Okay, in terms of if they have X, no? X itinerary and post, no? If they have social impact before, during, and later, when the project finished, okay? And this is the parameters of the project. This is a mixture between quantitative and qualitative, but mainly quantitative, okay? In terms, because we need, of course, when we talk about the impact, we talk about scientific, political, and social, okay? Scientific, of course, because if you are working, no, in a European research project, of course you need to publish, no, in ranking peer review journals and so on, okay? But it is also necessary to have a political impact and also social. And there is, of course, a direct relation between the three of them, okay? This is the three main, there are more, okay, in the impact, but this is three of the main important ones, no? The criteria and quantification of the social impact, ex ante and ex post of the research projects in Europe. The ex post evaluation of the social science and humanities projects for the two last framework programs from all the projects located in social science and humanities. And it's so difficult because there are, for instance, projects in arts and projects about economy. In social science and economy and humanities, there are a wide range of different, okay, projects. And the last one, and for me is, I want to show you, no, the creation of an open repository on research social impact, that is the SEER. Okay? This is the criteria that we are using, no, ex ante, in itinerary, and ex post, no, in order to reach, no, in order to know if a project has a really impact, no, social impact in the, no, in terms of the population. Okay. Normally, the European Commission, when they receive a project, of course, there is a director of the project, no, a future main researcher, and of course, there are different partners, and you can explain how you reach the social impact. Okay, and this is the first idea when you have, no, or when you write, no, the proposal of the project. Okay, of course, we are evaluating, no, this previous work. Okay, and the most important is during the research process. If they are using, for instance, methodologies, a more inclusive methodology, working with the population of Earth or with the stakeholders, yeah, because working in that way is more easy, no, to reach a social impact. And exposed, because sometimes it's so difficult to show a social impact when you are working. You need 1, 2, 3 years, no, in order to demonstrate really if your research has, no, a positive impact or not in the population. This is more some of the problems that we are finding. No? Researchers are not used to think about the work as generating social impact, because 3 or 5 years ago, it's not so common. No? It's not common to talk about, no, if you have social impact or not. Normally, the people, the researchers, are thinking more, no, in terms of the scientific impact of the research. Or, no, social impact goes beyond the research project lifespan, promise of attribution, also, if it is from your project or not, okay? And the last one, how to measure really the social impact, because it's not easy, really, not to measure this kind of social impact. Of course, the scientific impact you can measure, no? If you have 10, no, publications, 20, if it's in the first quartile of journal citation report or Scopus or this kind of databases, yeah, it's easiest, okay? Or in terms of policy impact, no? If your project has a resolution for the European Parliament or is more regional, no? If your government, in our case in Catalonia, no? If your regional government has a new policy and is directly related to your research, is easiest, more than the social impact, okay? Because with the social impact, it's so difficult, really, to establish, no, this impact. We distinguish, to arrive to the end, to the social impact, we distinguish the scientific publication, dissemination, transference, and later on, no, the social impact of the research. Okay? with the scientific publications, okay, these different journals. It's true that for the European Commission, it's not only if you are publishing in the first ranking journals, no, in Scopus or Journal Citation Reports. It's important also to publish in open system, okay, the open journal system, because the idea is you are receiving public funding from the European citizens, and the European citizens want to know which is the final result. And of course, if you are publishing in Scopus, but the journal is not open, okay, it's still reduced, and it's only for the researchers, okay. And this is, of course, an interest of the European Commission. And nowadays there are, every year there are more, and good, very good journals, no, in open system. The second idea is the dissemination, no? Takes place when institutions, companies, NGOs, no? And citizens at large got to know about our work, okay? And normally it's not using, no, these main publications in the journals, no? It's using social media, Twitter or Facebook or different media, social media from different, for instance, you can see, no, here the some news in the Figaro. This is because in one of the research projects that I will explain later, it included, in the midterm period of the project, we have a social media viewing, okay? And we invite from all the European countries the different journals, newspapers, okay? And this is one of the participants, no? But the idea is, if you are working in terms to have a social impact, you need to demonstrate and you need to disseminate the results. Because if not, it's so different. Because you can say, no, that you have social impact, but you need to know, and the people need to know. If not, it's only, no, in the research expertise. Yeah? And this is the other important criteria, the transparency, because the idea is you have a scientific impact, okay? You are publishing in journals, that dissemination, because these ideas published in articles are also disseminated, no, in other social media, okay? But it is necessary to transfer this to the political sphere, no, to have the political impact, okay? And of course, the policymakers, no, they want to have this information in order to apply, no, in new laws or in new, not laws, but some decrees, okay? Yeah. And one of the problems is in the last one, yeah, because they use the evidence provided by researchers to get worse social results. This is because in the past, okay, or now, there are many projects that they have no social impact, okay? And they develop their research, but without incorporating, no, the social actors doing the research, okay? They reach scientific impact, okay? But it's not clearly demonstrate how this has impact in social terms, okay? For instance, if I am a politician, okay, a policymaker, and I go to some published papers in some journals from a concrete research project, yeah. But this project has not a social impact. They have also only scientific impact in terms to have more papers published, no, in the journals. Of course, it's so difficult to have a positive social result in terms of the population. Okay, there are no connection, no, between the scientific sphere and the policymakers. Okay, and this is not a problem of the policymakers. Sometimes there is a problem, no, with the policymakers, but in some cases it's not this. The problem is not in the policymakers; it's in our research. No? If our research has no social impact, no, in terms of results, if the policymakers used this information, of course, the new laws, or if you want to introduce some concrete educational actions, and it's based in a research without social impact, of course, these new successful actions are not successful, okay? Because it's not based in something real, no, with a something with a social impact, no, with a real social impact, okay? And we said that there is a social impact, no, when transfer sells to achieve better social results, okay? When there is dissemination, transfer, you can say at the end, and also, of course, you need to demonstrate that you have a social impact. In this case, it's related with one of the results of the included project, because implementing successful educational actions in some concrete schools, they improve, no, the results, no, in this case, in basic competence in English. Okay? The idea is, for instance, if you are working in education, you are in the fourth of the targets, no, of the Europe 2020, no, related to improve, no, education. Okay? If you are increasing the results of the students, of course you are, no, you are working with social impact. Okay? And this is the idea, and this is that the European Commission wants, no, with this funding. In how to measure, okay, this is the CEO. I'm explaining first with the slides, and later we show you in the, because it's open and you can access, no, to the to information. Okay, this is the social impact open repository, yeah. And the idea is to incorporate that the researchers internationally incorporate the research in the database. The only, the criteria is that you need to demonstrate that with your research you have social impact. Okay, from 1 to 10, this is quantified from 1 to 10, and it's directly related with the targets of the European Commission, of the Europe 2020. Yeah, I'll show you. You need to introduce, no, the ORTIC. Is to identify, no, the identifier of the researchers. You need to create, no, like a, well, it's a platform you can enter. You need to identify with your ORCID, and later you need to incorporate the data, no, title of the project, the partners, the results, okay, and you send it to the system, okay. And there are a team working in CR, and they evaluate. Of course, they need to prove, no, that this is the project and that you really have these publications, and these publications is based, no, in a concrete social impact. And of course, it's connected to the targets of the Europe 2020. Okay. We incorporate, no, the description of the research project, principal investigator, the research team, the social targets, and the social impact. This is some of the criteria, the main criteria used, the connection to the United Nations Millennium Goals or the Europe 2020 targets. Percentage of improvement at the end. This percentage depends of the of your results. If you have, if you can demonstrate that you have more impact, of course your percentage of improvement during the project is higher than others. Okay? The transferability of the impact, you need to demonstrate also if your scientific publications has transferred, no, to the citizens. Publication is a scientific journal with recognized impact, and the sustainability. Because you can demonstrate, for instance, that you have a social impact, no, in a concrete period of time, but also the sustainability, no, over the years is also. Normally, if the project is based in Europe, the researchers connected to the Europe 2020 targets. Okay? But if it's international, in other parts of the world, normally they connected with the United Nations Millennium Goals. Okay? And normally it's similar. It's centered, no, in education, GDPs, also in the climate, no, in different international targets that are so common. It's not only. based in Europe. This is the percentage of improvement, for instance. If you can demonstrate that you are that your improvement is around the 30% or more, you obtain the score of 10. Okay, but the most important is if you have 1, 2, or 3, doesn't matter. The most important is with your research you have social impact, and you can found here. I don't know if it's more or less 50 projects now introduced in the base, no, in the CR. And the most important, of course, is better if you have 10, 9, or 8, okay? It's only to, because it's necessary, not to quantify, okay? But the most important idea is that the researchers working, no, in social science and humanities work in this line, no, to reach social impact. If you have 3, 4, or 5, okay, that's the matter. The important is working in that line. This is the idea, no? Even if the value is 1, it means a good result, okay? Because the idea is to have this impact. Okay? I prefer to show you because it's, if not, it's so abstract, no, the information, okay? Mm-hmm. This is the CR, okay? This is the direct link. You have here the criteria that I'm explaining, social impact criteria. This is the main goals. Okay. And this is the score. If I achieve more than 30% of the improvement, transferability at least implemented in two different contexts, because the idea also is trying to implement, for instance, the successful educational actions conceptualized during the included projects is now implemented in Latin America, or they are now implementing in the United Kingdom. No, the idea is if you discover or you conceptualize something that you can transfer to other context. No, this is also important. And if you have more than two different contexts, you have more score in these cases. Yeah. Or if you have one, no, connection to at least one target of the United Nations or the Europe 2020, have achieved some percentage of improvement. No? The idea is that you are working, no, in the line, no, priorized by Europe 2020, in our case, or in the United Nations Sustainable Development, or other international rankings. Okay, this is the main idea. If you want to reach, you need to connect with the ORCID to create, no, your profile, and there be introduced, no, title of your project, and the main targets. If you are working in education, you need to connect with the target 4, no, the Europe 2020. And then you need to put the information, no, related to the scientific impact, or if you have political impact, you need to put all the information. Okay? And you can enter and you can access to different projects. There is the Europe 2020 target that I showed you previously. With all the, no, this is the whole document from the European Commission. Okay. Okay. And here you need to introduce your project. In search, this is a more big project, not restoring Fukushima, woman in informal employment. This is, for instance, in included. I show you some of the impact related to this project. And you have the website, you can enter. The social impacts, okay. For instance, no, reducing absenteeism. The indicator is overcoming the absenteeism. And this is linked, no, to the fourth target from the Europe 2020. And the evidence, no, is the article. Normally you need to explain, no, the indicator and which is the evidence, no, to show that you have really, or the expansion in number of schools. Okay, this explanation about, no, the transference to Latin America, and the evidence is linked to this information. This is another one, but it's for, it's totally different. Atapuerca is more, Atapuerca is located in Burgos, also is in Spain. It's about archaeology. They work in archaeology. And for instance, no, creation of employment, because they discover many things, no, in Atapuerca. And of course they have a lot of scientific impact. They publish many articles in Nature, no, and in different scientific journals. Okay, but they have also this kind of impact, like because they create a museum, no, about with the fundings. They create hotels. They create employment in the area. And of course, it's directly related to the project. Not in terms of the contents, no, but it's related to the project. And they can demonstrate, no, that they create employment, for instance. And of course, this is directly related with the first target, no, of the Europe 2020. Okay? They explain shortly here, and they put one of the evidences. No? Normally, the idea is always the same. No? The description, the indicator related to the targets of Europe 2020, and later the scientific evidence. No? You need to put this information in the repository. And the main important is, the idea is all of you can enter, no, and to have a look at, no, the different research projects. Okay, you can upload it in the system. Of course, later there is a team, no, looking for, no, information if it's correct or not, and finally they published, no, open to the people. This is the example not included, okay, but I'll show you with the weapons, no, educational success and social inclusion in more than 100 communities, learning communities. These learning communities and the successful educational actions is our Saleacom center in this concrete area. And we have here the information, no, in terms of has achieved more than 30% of the improvement with the data to show the transferability, because it's transferred, no, to UK and Latin America. Always you need to put, no, the transferability, no, if you have more than 30% of improvement, or the social impact, no, the scientific in scientific papers. Okay, you need to demonstrate each of the terms. Well, this is to situate the social impact, the debate, no, internationally, and CR, because I think that you can use, no, to have a look and different, because there are more or less 50 projects, many different research projects with some interesting information, okay, and it's so international. And now, the most important for me, no, trying to link, no, the communicative methodology and the social impact, okay, to reach the social impact. The communicative methodology, I introduce a little bit some of the theoretical basis. No? It's based in the idea of dialogic societies, because egalitarian dialogue and interactions are one of the pillars of the communicative methodology. Okay? The idea of the people are not cultural idioms, no, that we can find, no, in the studies in ethnomethodology, no, of Carpenter. Or the idea of the monopolization of expert knowledge in Beck, in the modernization. The idea is using communicative methodology. Of course, we are incorporating the social actors during the whole research process. And of course, you need to break, no, with the traditional distinction, no, between subjects and objects of the research, and with the idea of the experts. Of course, are experts, no, in different research areas. No? The idea is experts are not experts if they do not dialogue with us. Okay? You can, of course, for instance, in my case, I'm not really, well, I'm an expert in communicative methodology. But the idea is, I don't need to demonstrate that I'm an expert. I need to connect with the people and to dialogue with them. This is the idea. It's linked to this demonopolization of the expert knowledge. And in Gartinkel, this is the idea that the social actors are critical thinkers also. Okay? And they, of course, can understand the social reality and they can transform it. Because the communicative methodology is also study directed to the social transformation. This is one of the main ideas, to reach this social transformation. Yeah. We have also Frege, pedagogic depressed, or Habermas, or Chomsky, the theory of the dialogic action, or in terms of Habermas, the differences between the system and the life world, the scientific community and social actors. With the communicative methodology, we are working always with dual theories. Okay, we know for sure that there are systems and the life world of the social actors, and the idea is if we want to reach a social impact and to have a transformation. Okay, we are working with vulnerable groups in order to overcome the situation of these vulnerable groups. It's so important to know the really the functioning of the system that. And the idea that it's possible to change the system. Of course, working with the people, with the life of the people. Chomsky is more, and also is in this idea in Habermas, the idea of the universal grammar, that all the people has, this capacity of language and action. The idea is working in a communicative process, in an egalitarian dialogue, an intersubjective dialogue, we can change the system. And this is possible internationally. For instance, if we are working with successful educational actions in Spain, and we demonstrate that it's possible to work in Mexico, in Brazil, or in Chile, or in the United Kingdom, it's because it works internationally. And the communicative methodology has also this orientation, more universalistic, okay? Like the theory of Chomsky or Habermas, or Frege, because he's also was thinking in the possibility to transform the world that is present in the pedagogy of the oppressed. And also some of the main ideas from the communicative perspective. Okay? It attempts to transform the social context through communicative actions. The research subject, this is the main idea is that the interpretation of the social reality is always in connection between the researchers and the social actors. Okay? And for the researcher, the more important is to incorporate, if we have the academic background and we have the knowledge, the academic knowledge, okay, we need to share with the social actors within this egalitarian dialogue, and with this information, the social actors they can connect the academic background with the life world, with the daily life histories. Okay, the idea is the system is represented by by this academic background, that we have as researchers. Okay, this is our role. Yeah, but the most important is all this information. For instance, if we are working, we are making a fieldwork for a research project. Okay, you need to incorporate this academic background in your guidelines. For instance, for an interview or for a focus group. Okay, or if you are designing a questionnaire, you need to explain all this background. Because it's so important that a social actor that is not a researcher, they have no time to research. They need to know this information. And with this information, they can connect this information with their vision, their own vision of the reality. Okay? And this is the is theory and practice at the same time. Okay? The interpretation of the reality is always at the same time. And it's different, for instance, from participatory action research or action research, because there are many different possibilities. Because normally they acting more in the practice, not in the praxis, not practical, and later they want to the theory, but this not a real connection between both at the same time. Always is this kind of spirit. No? They want to the field, they collect the data, normally qualitative, also quantitative, more qualitative, and later they connect it to the theory, they return to the field work. Okay? But it's normally more based in the practice. Okay? And with the communicative methodology, we are trying to establish a permanent dialogue with the people, okay, with the social actors. Are trying to explain the social reality and to transform the social reality with this egalitarian and intersubjectivity and intersubjective dialogue with the social actors. Okay, this is the idea, no? That's not imply the same knowledge. Of course, my knowledge is different, no? From no? The social actors. But the idea is contribute, no? To the dialogue of, no? With the accumulated knowledge of the international scientific community. Of course, the social actors, they can decide to use, no? The ideas, these ideas, the academic background, link it to their personal opinions or not. Yeah, but for us, it's important that the people, the social actors, has information. If they want to link with their personal reality or not, is in their hands. Okay, but we think that this, if you want more an ethical position, no, for us, no, they no, to share no, the information, no, the academic background. Okay, and the idea is. How we can organize, for instance, no, the project, no, the whole project, to have this kind of permanent dialogue, because for us it's so important, no, to try to establish, no, this permanently. Okay. And for instance, if we are working with the Roma population, no, or people from Morocco, or people arriving now, no, many people from Romania, no, arriving to spend in poor conditions, okay? The idea is how we can access, how we can work together, no? From the very beginning of the research project until the end, okay? Presenting the results, discussing, yeah? And of course, for instance, no, if we present the final results in a conference, trying to invite, no, the social actors to the conference in order to share and to present the results, okay? The idea is how we can organize in that way. And for us, it's clearly directed to the social impact. Okay, if you are working with the subjects and you are incorporating, no, during the research project, okay, of course it's easiest to have at the end social impact. Okay, and of course, if you are working more in the theoretical background, okay, for instance, if you are working with the Roma and you during the first 6 months of research, you need to establish, no, the literature review. Okay, if you access to some articles or books, you can easily find some many stereotypes of the Roma community also published in journals. Okay, there are many examples. Yeah, this is exclusionary research, and if you used this theoretical background in your research, your final product is also full of stereotypes. Okay, but if you are work with the people, with the social actors, if you include Roma researchers or Roma population during your research project, and they read a first draft, for instance, of the literature review, they say, this is racist, this is stereotyping, no, and you need to change. Okay, and this is the idea, and we work in that way. And of course, at the end, the final product, okay, has more impact than others, and is more related, is more rigorous, no, to the social reality of the, in this case, the Roma population, if we are working with the Roma population. this is the media. This is, for instance, this is Emilia Claveria, okay? She died 5 years ago. She was the first president of Trunco Tarvestipen, the association working with us in Saleacom, okay? She was a Roma woman, illiterate, okay? And in this picture is with a representative of the Catalan government, and they, this is the final presentation of the results of a research project, Workalo. I will introduce you some ideas later, because it's one of my examples of social impact. And through this dialogue between Emilia and this is Giuseppe Pander, no? This is the name of the politician, the policymaker, okay? At the end, Giuseppe Andreu say, no, that they want to incorporate the final results of the Workalo, okay, into a new resolution that was approved, no, in Catalonia, related to the recognition of the Roma population, no, of, as an ethnic group in Europe, and also in Catalonia and Spain. Okay? And this is because they have the opportunity to meet and to talk, establish this kind of dialogue. If not, it's not so. Not normally, many research projects, they have scientific impact. They work with the people, but only to obtain the data. But then, when they present the data, they present as scientists, no, as researchers, okay? And normally, they don't establish this kind of public spaces, no, with different researchers and non-researchers talking together. If you create these spaces, it's easiest. No? That it's possible, no, to establish this dialogue and this kind, no, if, this kind of improvement. And this is the idea, no? A junior researcher, a senior researcher, a social actor, no, in dialogue. Of course, it's possible, not, but if you have the possibility to talk, no, to establish this dialogue, it's easy, no, that at the end, you can reach a social impact, that you have a political impact or social impact. If not, it's so difficult. This is researcher with for the communities. This is the idea, no? Establishing this egalitarian dialogue with scientific evidences. And this is, for instance, no, in the case of the SEAS, is the successful educational actions, okay? Because the successful educational actions were identified, no, during the included. There is scientific evidences, but this is established because it was using communicative methodology, no, in an egalitarian dialogue. Okay? And later, this is the recreation of the successful educational actions, the transference to other contexts. This is the idea of having a social impact. This is one of the publications, no, of the communicative methodology. I can send you, Lucen, if you want the
slides, yeah.
PowerPoint,
yeah,
with the data. Now, three ideas, basic ideas of the communicative methodology. One is the communicative organization of the research, okay? That is so important. The other one is the communicative techniques, no? How we can establish the dialogue with the people in order to obtain the data. And the later, the last one, the third, is the analysis of the data. Because the organization, the communicative techniques, and the analysis, how we analyze the data, are particular of this communicative orientation. Yeah? This is used, for instance, in included, no, advisory committee, panel of experts, working groups, no, free task oriented groups. We use all these four different strategies, no, to organize the research. Okay, but I want to introduce the first one because for me it's the most recognized and most directly related with a communicative orientation. This is the idea of the advisory committee. In the case of included, no, was formed by 10 members of vulnerable groups, represented by youth, women, migrants, no, cultural minorities, with a trajectory in the overcoming of inequalities. Okay. The idea of an advisory committee, here, the example, is, for instance, and this is formed by the, this is Roma representatives, okay? If we are working with Roma, we don't want that the president of an association was part, formed part of the advisory committee. The idea is, if we are working with the Roma or with migrant, we want to have a migrant in poor conditions, or a Roma, an illiterate Roma, okay, that they need to improve, no, the conditions, not the president of the association. Okay? This is, we want to work, and we work with the most vulnerable of the vulnerable group. I don't know.
With presentative?
Yeah, because normally you connect always with the same people. The president of the Roma Association, or I don't know, or the president of the Latino, okay? And we want to work with the people. This is the, yeah.
And how do you select these people?
Because in our case, we have Roma researchers, no, in our center, no, or from other ethnicities. It's so so diverse, and they know the people. It's so easy because we have representatives of the, no, in this case, of the vulnerable group working. Okay, and also because some of them, like some of us, we are working also. For instance, I'm working as a volunteer, no, in a learning community, and of course, I have the academic background about the learning community, but also the practical, because I'm working, no? I'm act as a volunteer in the school. I know the theory of the successful educational actions, but I know how to reach and to interact with the people because I'm working in interactive groups or in the literary gatherings and so on. The idea is we are working in the academy, but also we have permanent links also with associations, Rancotar or others, no, work. And for us it's not so difficult to access, no, to the people. Of course, if we need to connect with Roma people, no, we connect with Rancotar or with other associations. And we need, no, to find people, no, with these characteristics, no, in order to participate in the project, no? And they connect, no, with the people. If not, it's not so easy. Because, for instance, in the case of the Roma community, they are so tired because there are many researchers going, no, to observe, to have data, but at the end, the results of the research project is nothing for them. It's possibly for the researchers because they have data, they can do this, and so on. But in terms of the community of the Roma, there are no success, and the idea is trying to avoid, no, these situations. For instance, in the case of Workalov, that I will introduce a little bit later, we established a advisory committee formed by Roma and non-Roma people, and researchers and non-researchers. Okay, and for instance, in the case of Workalov, the first meeting with the advisory committee was to discuss about the literature review, okay? And they found, as I'm explaining later, before, they found some stereotypes in the first draft, because we are using the theoretical background, the main publishers and so on, but sometimes in the way that you are writing, no, the report, appears these kind of things, okay? And talking with them, and normally we employ one morning, no, working together, present the results. Of course, we send previously the results, not to have time to read and later to discuss. But during the discussion with them, appears all these things. No? Or for instance, if you are planifying the field work, no, and you need to complete the guidelines for an interview or for a daily life history, or to create a questionnaire, you can send to the advisory committee all the drafts, no? 1 or 2 weeks before, and you can, during a morning, you can discuss. And they probably they say, no, if you use this kind of language, the people don't understand, no, that, and you need to change, or you need to modify, or whatever. Okay? But if you can validate, no, because it's with the advisory committee, you are validating your data. You are validating your first literary report, or you are validating if the guidelines for the fieldwork that is so important are really connected with the interest of the rural population or more local web of the social actors. Okay? And this is the idea of the, to have this constant dialogue among researchers, teachers, families, students, whatever, with all the social actors. The second is with this idea, getting more complete and accurate knowledge on the object of study. And this is the communicative data collection techniques. We have three, mainly communicative. This is the communicative daily life histories, the communicative focus groups, and the communicative observation. Okay? And the main difference between this and the non-communicative is the previous idea that I introduced. The idea is, I'm the researcher, okay? I have the academic background, the theory, yeah? And I need to put it in the paper, okay? If I'm collecting data, with I'm talking with people from Morocco, okay, I need to show that we have a previous report about the theory, okay, and the main ideas are incorporated in the data. Always we connect the theory, this academic background, okay, with the objectives, of course, and the hypothesis of our research, okay, and we put it always in these guidelines, in these questions, okay? And in this case, they can connect or not with their daily life histories. It's so clear, for instance, we developed the first project in Spain. It was about gender violence in the universities, okay? And of course, we found a lot of data internationally, United Kingdom, in the States mainly, showing that of course there is gender violence at the university between teacher against students, between students, okay? But if you try to find information in Spain, it's nothing, because it's not a problem of the universities. It's more linked, 10 years ago, it's linked to more the people with the literate people, the people with the resources, this kind of idea, okay? And we broke with this. But we broke with this because we went to the scientific community, what happens in other countries, and we used the data in order to create the questionnaire and the qualitative guidelines. Okay? Because if not, there are many people not thinking 10 years ago that there is no problem in the higher education institutions. And we know 10 years ago for sure that was not, the reality was so different. But the main problem is that nobody broke with this idea, okay? But to break with this, it's so important to incorporate the data, the academic background, to the practice. The people need to know this reality. And the third, identify those educational actions, in this case, because this is used for included, to overcome educational and social inequalities, okay? But the main idea is that we always work with exclusionary and transformative dimensions, always with these two axes, with these two dimensions. And of course, change the categories. This is the categories, in order to analyze the information, okay? But always is exclusionary dimension and transformative dimension. Okay? For instance, in the case of included, we use transformation of the neighborhood, transformation of the lives of the participants, other transformations. Okay? Of course, you can find information related, for instance, with health, exclusionary or transformative. For instance, if you find that years before, in the neighborhood, the social services and the health services, they prefer to don't go because it's a danger neighborhood. They want, of course, this is exclusionary. Okay, but if you find later that the social services change this position and they go to the neighborhood, they work with the people, they try to overcome. Because normally in the neighborhoods that we work in the included has many health problems. If you are working to change this situation, we put this information in the transformative dimensions. Okay, the idea is to have at the end exclusionary dimension and transformative. Okay, the exclusionary are the barriers, okay, the problems, yeah, and the transformative dimension is how we can overcome the problems, yeah, and the main point is all this information, okay, is related with the people. It's through the dialogue with the social actors, with the people, that we establish, no, this is exclusionary or this is transformative. And it's in the words, no, of the people that they say, no, this is the problem, but also this is the solution, the possible solution. Okay? And it's not only based in the voice of the people, it's based in the voice of the people and also of the researcher in this egalitarian dialogue. And working in that way, no, we think that it's possible, and we have in some of the examples that I show you now, to have this kind of social impact, no, between the people. This is the included, no? This is formed by six projects, because it was a very big project, formed by six different projects, 22 case studies successful in unsuccessful centers, six longitudinal studies, no, from 2006 to 2011. This is one of some of the publications. But the idea is that with included, we have many examples of political impact, because this is different resolutions from the European Commission directly linked with some of the results of the included. Okay. In 2009 and 2011, in 2009 was the intermediate period of the project, and there was a conference in Brussels, in the European Parliament, okay? And it was present by the first time the successful educational actions, the conceptualization of, no, the successful educational actions. And in 2011, was presented the final results of the project. And in both, the most important people was the social actors. In 2009, was José, El Pastor, who El Pastor is a priest, but in the Roman community is evangelist, okay, and they called the pastor, but he's a priest, okay. He was working in the project with us, and he was so involved in the running community, in the neighborhood, and he presents the results in the European Parliament, okay. Who was so powerful. And in the end, in 2011, Rafael Ayón or Ania Ballesteros, Rafael Ayón was a father participating in the school. Ania was a 10 years old child from another learning community, and they present the data of the project. Okay? And this is the idea, that you can incorporate the social actors during the whole process from the communicative organization of the research, but also if you are presenting the final results in the European Parliament, okay, it's important that the main researcher, of course, present the results with members of the research team, but at the same time, it's so important that the people, the social actors, present also the results at the same level. The idea is the most important is the arguments, okay? Not the position, yeah? I can be an expert of the methodology, but it's so powerful if the final results are presented by a student more than me. Okay? This is the combination. Yeah? This is one of the results of the included. This is, no, from 2010 to 2014, no, the student graduation from secondary school, reaching, no, this is the increasement, because they are applying the successful educational actions. This is an example of social impact, because they are overcoming, no, the school failure, and you are obtaining better results. Okay, this is in one of the learning communities in Spain. And the last one, this is the workalo, the creation of occupational patterns for cultural minorities, the Roma case. Yeah, and this is the final presentation in the European Commission. Well, this is Jesús Gómez Pato. One of the main authors, no, in communicative methodology. At the end, it was Josep Andreu, no, member of the Spanish Parliament. This is to Linus Lennon was the main director of the Social Science and Humanities in this period, in 2004. Livia Jaroka, member of the European Parliament, and is a Roman representative. Okay. And this is the picture, no, between Emilia Claveria and Josep Andreu talking, no, in the presentation. Okay, and how Josep Andreu has the compromise to go to, no, return to Catalonia and to present, no, the recognition of the Roma population in Catalonia and later in Spain. First, it was approved, no, in Europe, 28th of April 2005, no, considered recognition of the Romani people as a European minority, but it was so important, no, in terms of a political impact and in terms of the Roma population. Yeah. And this is Josep Andreu in the September 2005, some months later, in the Catalan Parliament. This is the Catalan Parliament, and was approved also in Spain, in the Parliament of all the Spain. In Spain, we work in different regions. Okay, in Catalonia, we have our government. Okay, and we have some in terms of employment or education. This is different. No, the law is different. And this is the Catalan Parliament where they approved the recognition of the Roma population. And this is some of their resolutions, directly or sometimes indirectly related with the inclusion, taking early school leaving, or the social dimension of the vocational training, or the strategy of Roma inclusion. And because the with included was from 2006 to 2011, and during these 5 years, there were many different longitudinal studies and with many, many qualitative and quantitative data, and using, no, the communicative methodology. And of course, the European Commission used this data, no, in order to, no, to improve, no, different decrees, resolutions, and whatever. And this is different examples of political impact or social impact, and all is always linked with this idea to working at the same level, no, with the social actors. And we have at least 10 minutes to talk.
Questions, comments?
I was really interested in how you talk about participants being involved throughout the whole research. When I posed that idea for my research proposal, there was some concern from my supervisor that I wouldn't pass through ethics because they would expect that participants would only have to be involved with the research between 1.5 to 2 hours. Because my participants are Māori, we do have that saying of we are the most researched in the world. I think Roma would probably say that too. How do you get around that if you want to involve people for the lead from your project?
For the communicative organization, for instance, for the advisory committee, we create a concrete contract with the people. It's so clear, no, from the beginning, which is the role of each participant, no, and we, of course, we write this kind of, if you want, it's not a contract. No, okay, in order to have the clear idea, which is the, no, the main idea of the advisory committee, and of course, sometimes members of the advisory committee moved, because if the project is from 3 years, no, and sometimes you need to replace a people, no, because a person, no, because they say, well, I'm working now, it's so difficult to manage, and you need to find another people, but with the same conditions. And this is for instance, with the advisory committee. When we are making the field work, we need to connect with many different people, because we need to pass a questionnaire or whatever. We have, of course, ethics. And we have, each person needs to feel, no, the ethical compromise. But I think that in Spain, more than here, I think, for instance, in our university, in Rovira y Virgili, it's the first time that they approve an ethical in the Saleacom, it was necessary to prove that we have the ethical, no, that it's okay working with the, no, with the social actors. Okay? And the European Commission needs to show or to have a proof that we have this kind of ethical, no, background. And in Tarragona, this is so powerful in chemistry or medicine or whatever, okay? In health. And it's so clear if you are working in health, which is the protocol, okay? But not in social science, in social sciences, not in, in education. And for instance, for the European Commission, we have the proof of ethics, but this is signed by health, a health committee, because there is no a concrete, no concrete committee on education, okay? But this is an institutional problem, if no, if you want. The idea is that for us, of course, we have, no, if we pass the questionnaire, no, to 500 people, we need to have 500 compromised, compromises. No, with this is the objective of the research. This is why we need, no, to you fill all this kind of. But I think it's different here.
Gracias, Aitor. Do you think communicative methodology and participatory action methodology are similar or the same methods or methodology? Just with different titles?
No, no, I think that it's more, there are more similarities than differences. Mm-hmm. Okay? I established some differences because I think that the way to act, the theoretical background is different, no, from the both approaches. But for instance, in the case of participatory action research, the idea to incorporate the social actors, no, and to give voice to the people that normally have no voice, is all, is also in the action research or the participatory action research, or the orientation towards social transformation. Is also present in the participatory action research. There are many examples, no, that, trying to improve, no, the living conditions, no, or of vulnerable groups working with the participatory action research. I think that the main idea is that normally the participatory action research put more emphasis in the voices of the social actors. Okay, and in our case, we try to combine at the same level, no, trying to connect the theoretical background with the direct knowledge of the population, of the, well, the social actors. And working in this way is, the final result is different. Yeah? Because normally the social actors link, no, the theoretical background with their own, their own experience. Okay? And it's different, no, for this reason. And of course, in participatory action research, there are many, many different research groups working, and in many different ways. But normally, mainly they work with qualitative, more than quantitative, and giving more, no, importance to the social actors in this case.
Thank you. Sorry. So do you share that theoretical perspective then with the community, with those social actors when you go in? Did you say that?
For instance, when we go to the community, mm-hmm. and we collect the data, we try to connect always the theoretical background with the reality. Of the, for instance, if I'm collecting data with Roma and I'm making a daily life history, yeah, of course I'm introducing questions about the past, no, for the people. But if I'm thinking, no, in I have always my objective of the my objectives of the research. And I have the previous literate review present, and I'm introducing it during the dialogue. Mm-hmm. This
so,
is the,
yeah.
the idea.
Can you just talk a little bit more about your Roman participant, their response, their reaction when they hear about your presentation of like introducing this theory and the literature review to them? Is there a good response from them?
With the Roma?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course. No, for instance, Because they are so tired with from us, from the researchers.
Mm-hmm.
We are some of our Roma members that working with us in the in CREA, in our research center. They create the CEG, is the Center of Roma Studies, okay, Centro de Estudios Gitano, yeah. And the main idea is, and they create, no, 5 years ago, a protocol to work with the Roma.
Mm.
Okay, if you are a researcher and you want to work with our community, you need to follow a protocol. Okay, and of course, within this protocol is you need to share the results, you need to consult with the people. Yeah. If not, they don't want to work with you. Okay. But this is more in our case working in this with this orientation, because for us it's an ethical compromise also. Okay. If not, there are many Roma that they don't want to participate. But there are many research projects, many results that sometimes is used against the Roma to stereotype more than